Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, we are diagnosing this Suzuki with ESP warning light on. As you see, engine is running right now, but on the instrument cluster, I have ESP off light on. So in this video, we're gonna proceed to read the code from this system and see how we can repair this car. And for diagnosing this system, we're gonna use this scan tool, which is from the top down. Here's the model RTDI 800BT. This is actually one of the latest models of top down budget scan tools. I like the design because the resolution of the screen is really good. At the back, you don't see any bracket, but what I like is this section on this side of the scanner, which gives you really good grip when you are working with that. And VCI is just right here. So you can just keep the VCI right there, just like this. And anytime that you wanna use it, it's gonna come out and you can connect it to the OBD2 connector. So we're gonna go ahead to see if this scan tool can do anything for diagnosing and fixing this car. If you're interested to learn more about this scan tool or other top down products, you can find the link in the video description or the first comment down below. And before starting the video, if you guys haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please don't forget to subscribe. For supporting us, you can like the video or share it with your friends. So I'm gonna go ahead to connect the VCI to OBD2 connector first. So OBD2 connector for this car is located right here. I'm gonna connect the VCI. Let's go ahead. As you see on the first page, we have a couple of options for diagnostic, for the maintenance. If you go in there, as you see, we have all the options for maintenance that we normally call it as special functions. So let's go back. We're gonna go ahead to see what's going on with this car first. On this page, you can go for the wind detection for auto wind, or you can enter the wind from here, or you can go ahead to find and select the car from the list of cars that you see right here. As long as we are here, we're gonna go for the Suzuki to see how we can select the car manually. Alto, it's after 2009. Transmission is automatic. Confirm. So right here we have the auto scan that we can go ahead to read the code for all systems on the car. And hot functions are those special functions that we can use for this car. If you go in there, for example, oil reset, steering angle sensor calibration, TPMS reset, immobilizer key, and that's it. We're gonna go back to auto scan. Right here we have the list of all systems. We're gonna click on auto scan, and of course system is gonna communicate with all the systems on the car. As you see, we already have some fault codes on powertrain system, ABS and ESP. So this is what we are concerned. This is where we have that fault code. So just waiting for all the systems. So these are fault codes. Two systems, power steering and airbag, they are normal, but we have these fault codes right here. So we read the fault code, and this is a good sign that this scan tool is covering all the systems. For example, if you go for this one, you can read the fault codes for ESP. As you see, most of them are history, 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 but one of them is current. So these codes that are shown as history, of course you can erase them, there's nothing wrong with them, but this one, which is current, is giving us the fault code for steering angle sensor calibration. It means we need to perform the calibration for this sensor. I'm gonna go ahead to erase the code first, but still we have this fault code that we need to do something for it. As you remember, we had one option on the special function for this car for steering angle sensor calibration. I'm gonna go ahead to perform the calibration to see if I can perform it, and then if I'm able to erase the fault code. On the data stream, let's have a look at the data stream for ABS and ESP system. So if I go down on steering angle sensor, this one, I can select the option from here. So I'm gonna have this one only. And if I turn the steering wheel, so I'm turning the steering wheel right now, but as you see, I'm not getting anything. So the steering angle sensor is not showing anything to me. So that's why I have the fault code. Just in case, if you are reading the live data in this section, of course, I'm not getting anything, but you can go for the graph mode as well. Of course, if I turn the steering wheel right now, because I'm not getting any data, this graph is not gonna change. but this scan tool covers the graph mode as well, so you can read the graph from here. So let's go back. We know that the problem is from the calibration, special function, sensor calibration. So this function serves to calibrate all the sensors used in electronic stability program at the same time after replacing the electronic stability program hydraulic control unit. So any sensor that you have, like the steering angle sensor, yaw rate and G sensors, will be calibrated by doing this. So we're gonna go ahead to perform the calibration. Make sure the vehicle is under the blue condition. Ignition switch on, engine must be stopped, so engine is running. I'm gonna stop the engine, but I keep the ignition switch on. Parking brake operating, it's on. Steering wheel should be straight, which is straight. Brake pedal should be off, which is off. So let's go ahead. Stabilization communication in progress. It's complete. Press exit to return. So we performed the calibration. So let's go back. We're gonna go for reading the code. So as you see, there is no fault code anymore because we needed to perform the calibration, and after calibration, everything is back to normal and fault code is already gone. And right now that we have the calibration done and the fault code is gone already, let's go back to the data stream. So down here we had the steering angle sensor calibration that we did not have any value right here. I'm gonna click on the this one. After turning the steering wheel, as you see, the data is changing. And if I go for the graph mode right now, so you remember this one wasn't changing. So right now I have the steering angle sensor working, and that's great. All right, guys, this is what we wanted, to be able to read the code and to fix the code. And of course, this scan tool is capable of doing that. As usual, I'm gonna make more videos from this scan tool later on. So keep an eye on the channel, and please don't forget to have the channel subscribe to get the notification when we upload new videos. Thank you very much, guys, for watching.